Recently, I recorded a video on CSS linear gradients. In this video, we'll go a step further and investigate the radial and conic alternatives. Hello and welcome. Thank you for coming and joining me in this video. My name is Artur, and here at my channel, I'm showing you various web dev ideas. Linear gradient is only one of the possibilities that CSS can bundle with. The other ones are radial and conic gradients, which we are going to investigate in this episode. Personally, I love what radial gradients can do to your logos. Let's jump right into the code. Today I'm going to use inline styles to show you how to create radial and conic gradients. So let's add style. A gradient is a kind of a background, so we need to set the background property on our elements. And instead of an URL that we would normally use with an image, instead we are using the function radial gradient. In this function, we can provide two colors as the basic form. So let's start with black and dark cyan. And here it is. We have our gradient in here already. Of course, instead of names, we could use hexadecimal values like 00000, and we could also use decimal values like here. Nothing changed in here, so that's good. However, to keep things simple, I'm going to stick to the named values. As the first parameter of the radial gradient function, we can provide the position of the center of the gradient. By default, it is center. At center. We can also change it to, for example, left. And now the center is aligned to the left side. We can set it to right, to top, or to bottom. We can also use corners, so bottom left would move the center to the bottom left corner. Top right would move it here. Once the center of the gradient is set with the sides, we can offset it a little. So for example, 30% from top and 30% from right. And this centered has moved from here. We can set it also in pixels. So that's not really visible. Now it's better. Let's go back to the center. We can add more colors if needed. So between black and dark cyan, I am going to add cyan. And here it is, we have this ring in here. By default, it is in the middle between the black and the dark cyan colors. The dark cyan color in here is visible only here at the very far corner. We could change the size of this gradient. To do so, let's put here, for example, 30 pixels at center. The whole complete gradient has 30 pixels radius, so that's very small now. Instead of a fixed pixel size in here, we can replace this pixel value with a keyword. The possibilities include the sides or corners, closest or farthest. So for closest side, the gradient now fills everything up to the side. You can see here the dark cyan color. It is at the exact line of the side. Instead of a side, we could also use corner. And now it's bigger. It is actually what we had at the default. Instead of closest, we could use farthest. But because it is square, we can't really see that. So let's resize our element. I've set the height to 100 pixels and wow, actually the gradient is no longer circle, it is ellipse. By default, the gradient has the form of ellipse. If we wanted to change it to a circle, I need to put here circle. And now we can see it very clearly. So this gradient is of the shape of a circle and it has the size of the furthest corner, which is any of those. When I change the farthest corner to farthest side, the gradient now finishes in here. If I change the farthest side to to closest, look, the circle is much smaller. It now touches the sides that are at the top or the bottom. Just to make this example fully comprehensive, now I will change the circle to ellipse. And I'm back with the shape covering all my rectangle. This is exactly the same as if I removed ellipse at all, because ellipse is the default shape. Right, let's make this square again. And let's create this gradient from scratch. Now I will provide three colors: black, dark cyan, and black again. So it looks like a kind of dark sun. However, in this particular example, I want to provide also sizes. So the black would be at the very center of my gradient. The dark cyan, I want to take only 10 pixels. And black, I want to set another 10 pixels, so it would be up to the size of 20 pixels. So now I've got this nice ring in here. If I wanted the gradient to repeat now, I can do that easily by changing the function from radial gradient to repeating radial gradient. And now I have this nice hypnotic shape in here. Notice that when I put this gradient in smaller box, the sizes of the rings are exactly the same, because I used pixels, not persons. So here in the history where the boxes are twice smaller, the rings are exactly the same size. I could possibly change the sizes, and that would change the size of this gradient. In the final example, I will try to overlay three gradients, one on top of each other. So let's start from scratch. I've got background, and I want to add three radial gradients. They all will be circle. The first will be red, but I don't want it to be fully opaque. I want some little transparency in here, so I will set it to AA. The end color will be transparent. Now I will copy this gradient and create another one. This one wouldn't be red, it would be green. Now I will add a third gradient. And this one will be blue. Let's save and see what we have. So we have this, well, I didn't expect that really. It is orangey, like a sun. Why we got this? This is because every single gradient in here is positioned at the very center of this element. So let's move it. The top I will move to the bottom. The second, the green one, I will move to the top and left. And the bottom one, the blue one, I will move to top, right. Something went wrong. Ah, I forgot up in here. Cool, so now we have those three colors, red, green and blue, mixing smoothly in here. As an alternative to radial gradients, we can use conic gradients. The radial gradients radiate from the center outside. So the colors go from the center, they change as we go away from the center. In case of a conic gradient, it is slightly different. Let's see that. I'm going to remove everything from here and we will create a conic gradient. By default, we provide two colors, black and dark cyan. For conic gradients, we start at the very top. Here we have the black color, and now we rotate around the center, and as we go with the rotation, the color gets lighter and lighter until it gets to destination color, which in here is dark cyan. By default, conic gradient starts at the top. However, we can rotate it. In the first parameter, I will set from 45 degrees. Now it starts at the top right corner. Of course, I can also change it, for example, to 90 degrees or move to minus 90 degrees, so everything is possible. Similarly to linear gradients, I can also use here turns. So from zero turn. So no turn at all, that is top, the default state. But I can also make it half a turn. So now it starts at the bottom, or I can go with 0.25 turn and it starts from the right side. Of course, if needed, we can specify more than two colors. So I will remove everything from here and add here red, green and blue. So we have three colors. Let's go with a rainbow. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Save, and here it is, rainbow in the shape of a conic gradient. Finally, let's experiment with the colors in my company logo. So that would be black and dark cyan again. I don't like this edge in here. So what I'm going to do is add another color to my gradient. That would be black again. And now here I have a black. At half of the path, I have the dark cyan. And then again, I'm moving back to black. Let's add fourth color in here, cyan. It looks really nice, but again, we have this sharp edge in here. So I will finish with black again. And now it's looking really amazing. I want to finish this video by creating a logo. So I will get rid of this element and instead I will add here a D for a logo. The logo will have a ghost font awesome icon in the middle. This is an icon that I have found by looking over font awesome, looking for an icon that is free and that I could use as a kind of a placeholder for a logo. Of course, you would probably use some other file. I chose font awesome because it has the SVG codes in here. So now I can simply paste it in here and save, and I have this ghost in here. It is huge right now and it is black. So let's start by setting the fill of this image, this path. I'm setting this fill to white. And the ghost is white now. Now let's add some styling. I'll use inline styles, so they are in the same spot, so you can see clearly everything in a single place. Normally you would extract those to external CSS file. Let's start by adding temporarily a border for this logo div so we see what's going on. So logo, border, 1 pixel solid white. Okay, I see the border of the logo is here. External CSSs make it square the same size as we were working a few moments before with all those gradients. Now, I want this SVG here to be much smaller because it is overflowing the size that I have available. So I will style in here, logo SVG. So I'm styling this element now and I'll set its height to 60%. Now it's time to position it to be in the very center. There are multiple options how to do that. Recently I recorded a video showing you 4 ways. Which one I'll go with? Probably with the grid one, which I like the most. So display, grid, and place items, center. And this ghost is in the very middle right now using just 2 lines. For other ideas how to center an image inside a div, see my other video. I will add a link to it in the description. Now, instead of a square, we want here a circle. So let's use border radius for that. 50%. So the radius starts at the 50% and ends at the 50%. This way, we got a nice circle. Now, actually, I don't need this border at all anymore. Instead, we will add here the radial gradient background. Let's start by setting it to be a circle. The colors would be the same as my logo, so that's dark cyan and black. Wow, it looks creepy. It is a ghost on a blurry background. All right, let's modify it a little. I will change the size. The size of this logo div is 300 pixels and I want the gradient to be the same size, so I will set it to 300 pixels. Circle. Okay, it's looking different now. Now let's move the center of the gradient a little. Let's make it at the bottom left. Cool, but now the center is here. So maybe let's move it a little. So bottom 50 pixels and left 50 pixels. Better. Let's add a little more. 80. And I think it's looking really 3D now, as if it was not a circle, but a ball. So finally, let's add the drop shadow as in the other video. So filter, drop shadow, 0, 0, so it's not moved around. So I want the shadow of this logo exactly where this logo is. I want it to spread for 5 pixels and be black. Finally, I will just copy this and put it also for the ghosts. And that's the logo complete. I really hope you enjoyed this video and that this idea will help you use CSS gradients in your projects or create your own CSS based logos. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe. Please let me know in the comments down below what other ideas and challenges you would like to see here. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.